Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to make some chili cheese fries. I made a cheese fries casserole for you not too long back, and I remember somebody said, "Where's the chili?" So I decided not to make a casserole this time, but just to layer it. And we would have our chili cheese fries, but on the bottom will be the fries. Over that we'll spread some chili, and over that we'll have some cheddar cheese. And then it will just go into the oven long enough to melt that cheese, because I'm going to cook the french fries first. Actually, what I have here is a 26-ounce package that were frozen, french fries that were frozen. These are extra crispy, supposed to be extra crispy on the outside and very tender on the inside. Golden crinkles. Now you can use any kind of french fry that you want. If you want to make them from scratch, that's fine. You just need some cooked french fries. And I am doing these in stages. So I've done half of them. You can see these are nice and crispy already. They're ready to spread in the bottom of a large Pyrex dish and be covered with the chili and cheese. So what I need to do right now is to do my second batch. I'm going to turn my oil back on. I'm using peanut oil, about an inch or so in this pot. So you need a heavy pot if you want to do this on the stovetop. And then I'm going to test this and make sure it's hot. It should sizzle. It was just used a few minutes ago, so I think that will be fine. And drop them into the oil. And you can hear the oil sizzling, so that means it's hot enough. It needs to be about 350 degrees. And I have thawed these french fries. It will work if you put them in there frozen. But if you want to just go ahead and thaw them, that's less time they'll have to be in the oil. So give me a minute, I'll get these done matching the others. My french fries are nice and golden brown, so I'm going to turn them off. And you see I have my prepared plate here. It's a platter with paper toweling on it. I want to drain as much of this grease as possible. You see the grease streaming from them, so just shake it a little bit and bring it over to the plate. And we're going to be using the entire package, the 26-ounce package of french fries. So this is going to be a significant dish. It's going to be very large, but it's going to be really good for parties and things like that. And it would be less expensive for you to buy your materials, like I'm going to show you, and then put it together yourself instead of buying from a fast food place or restaurant. So here we have our prepared fries. So I'm going to let those sit there just a minute so that the paper towel can absorb a little bit more of the oil. And then the next step is to put them right in to a large casserole dish. This is a 13x9x2 inch dish. So I'm going to pick this up and slide those in on the bottom. Now, you could make your own homemade chili if you wanted to, but the whole idea here is to have a quick and easy snack that you can put together in almost no time. And so I've chosen this chili with no beans. You could use chili with beans, that's fine, but you want it hot. So go ahead and have it heating at the same time, because if you put cold chili on there and then put it in the oven and wait for it to heat up, these will be soggy and soaked, and I don't think you'll be very pleased with them. So I'm just going to put enough chili on there for a person to get a little taste of chili, but not so much that the whole dish will end up soggy. So it might be just one can that's needed, just whatever you like. If you like them soggy, that might be an option. It might be something that you would prefer, but just try to touch most of them and leave them so they are still finger friendly, and people at a party could maybe pick them up, or they can be eaten with a fork. I'm trying to make them fairly equally spaced in terms of putting that out, but I'm not going to use the full two cans. You can see I've probably got half can left there, if not more. So that goes back to sit on the stove, and it's just not needed. I'll eat it with crackers or something sometime. Now for the cheese. sharp cheddar cheese, and this is finely shredded. I put out 2 cups here, but I'm just gonna kind of look at this and see what I think will be good, because we don't want it too cheesy, but then we want it to be nice and tasty. And this is going on hot chili, and then it's going in the oven, so it will not be long at all before that's just right for eating. I think that looks good. So I'm gonna put it in a 400 degree oven. That's a little hotter than I usually use, but we want this done very quickly because everything is nice and crisp and hot right now. We don't want to let anything get soggy. So here we go, and I'll see you back in probably about 5 minutes. Our chili cheese fries have just come out of the oven. Remember, I put them in at 400 degrees. I left them on bake for 2 minutes, and then I turned them to broil for 2 minutes so they could get some heat from the top and the bottom. And now I'm just going to put some out on a little serving dish. So we'll come over here to the edge, and you can see that an individual portion might look like that. Honestly, my husband and I do not eat things that are this fatty very often, so I would probably, for myself, have just a small portion and then hopefully have something like a salad to go with it, or some vegetables or an apple. But you know, when it's party time, all bets are off. You can have whatever you want, and I feel like it's what you do most of the year. It's not what you do on one day when you're having a party, or one season like Christmas season when you're having different kinds of food. If you just go back to your normal diet afterward, then you're fine. So this is what it looks like, and I think it's going to taste mighty good. Let me just take a bite that has a little bit of each. I think you're going to like it. It's really, really good.